Hey, vinyl community, and welcome YouTubers from everywhere. Gonna have a little vintage audiophile fun here for you. Gonna show you my professional Marantz cassette deck, which I bought new, and I dug it out of the closet here not long ago to see what it could do. Here is my Marantz PMD-502 professional cassette deck. In the early 90s, I bought this unit brand new. It was never used very much, mostly been in a bedroom closet for many years. I dug this out and hooked it up to the vintage system to have a little fun with it. It works perfectly. It has a lot of controls on it for Dolby A, B, and C, a couple other things, has azimuth adjustment, several other things on it, and it's just really a nice unit. I used this in my recording studio back in the days when we also made cassette tapes to match the CDs we were doing.
In this path, very well. Mama's gone, goodbye. It ain't no use to sigh. I mean no use to cry. For you taught me right.
Yeah, I'm not going to start collecting cassettes. I got a big box of cassettes that I've kept, and they've probably been in the garage in the hot summers. Who knows what kind of condition they're in, but I picked up a Pink Floyd cassette at my store the other day, and I'll pick up a few of them just for fun. So, hope you enjoyed this little quick look at my Marantz professional cassette deck. Like many of you back in the day, I love making mixtapes. This is kind of one of blues, a lot of female singers, modern records like Bonnie Raitt, people like that, got Jelly Roll Morton, other stuff on here. I still got a big box of mixtapes, dig them out and try a few of them. To demonstrate the cassette deck, you're going to hear a little bit here off of this tape.
In 1985,
those JBL 250 Ti speakers were near the top of the food chain, I think, for audiophile speakers. Certainly were very good back in their day, so let's see how they sound on a good old audiophile record. Or a silver quintet and trio. This 2010 reissue by Analog Productions. Lacquer cut by Kevin Gray, pressed at RTI, 2 LP, 45 RPM. So here's a little taste of what this sounds like on a vintage system. We'll be right back. think the days of getting all analog records remastered from the original tapes are starting to draw to a close. So I've been trying to pick up as many as I can. I just got a little batch here fairly recently, and I'm going to show you a few of them here. Gillian Welch, this record, really great. This is a reissue, all from the original analog tapes. Great sounding record. Same thing, again, reissued recently. And I grabbed these. Michael Fremmer did his thing here a couple months ago. 100 all analog records that are still available. I had some of them, and I've been picking them up since I watched that. I now have 45 out of the 100. And a few of the records I've got, you know, just other issues of them. I probably won't go for a different copy. One that was highly recommended was this one, Oscar Peterson Trio. We get requests from Analog Productions, almost easy listening Oscar Peterson, and I wanted to order this record. It had been back ordered at Analog Productions, and the cheapest copy you can find on Discogs is about $75, so I thought, well, I'm just going to put in a back order at Analog Productions, and so that I don't miss out on it. And luckily, come in the mail the other day, great sounding record. Of course, the Tone Poet series, people been showing and talking about them. I just picked up this one. This is one probably not quite as popular as some of the others. New Bottle, Old Wine, Gil Evans, the great jazz composers, interpreted by Gil Evans and his orchestra. Almost a little big bandy, but St. Louis Blues, W.C. Handy, King Porter Stomp, Jelly Roll Morton, Willow Tree, Fats Waller, Strutting with Some Barbecue, Louis Armstrong's little wife at the time, Jill Harden Armstrong, Lester Young, Thelonious Monk, Charlie Parker. Boy, I'm happy to get that one. Everybody's been showing the cornbread. Of course, I picked that one up. You get these things from Amazon, $27, free postage. I think they're hard to beat. Another one in the Tone Poet series that probably never see anybody else show it. This is one of the newer Blue Note records that they reissued in this series. And I'm really happy to get it. Cassandra Wilson Glamored. And I have several other Cassandra Wilsons, several of them that were shown in that Fremmer video of 100 analog records, and that's when I started picking them up, and I really like them. She's an excellent singer and an excellent pianist, and just a lot of really good tunes on here. This one I think is $42 because it's a double LP, but still. One that Fremmer showed, Burnt Weenie Sandwich, Frank Zappa. This is pressed at Palace, the all audiophile quality record. Doc and Merle Watson, not only all analog audiophile record, this is all stuff that was never issued before. These tapes were found, a live performance, Never the Same Way Once, live at the boarding house from 1974, 45 RPM, double LP. I love Doc and Merle Watson, and this is one that most of you won't be familiar with because it was never issued till recently, and if you like those father and son duo, grab that record. Janice Starker, Analog Productions, from the Living Presence series, Antal Dorati and the London Symphony Orchestra. Just a great sounding record. I want to get that one where he's just playing the Bach cello, but it's been back ordered. They do have a real fancy kind of box set of it, but I'm going to pick up that one. My buddy Paul says that's the best sounding record in his collection. And following along with Rockin' Ronnie and these Rhino vinyl records from 2011. I think this was maybe the Grateful Dead's first record. This was reissued on Rhino vinyl, 2011. A lacquer cut by Chris Bellman and pressed at Palace. So I'm happy to add that one to the Grateful Dead collection. And Analog Productions here, recent record, Freddie King. All analog from the original tapes. Got Leon Russell on piano, and a number of these Freddie King things have Leon Russell on keyboards, and that really adds to them. Duck Dunn on bass. I mean, grab these things while you can. And ordering a little Freddie King music on vinyl generally sounds almost as good as those other records do. So just grab this one was while I was at it. So I say keep them spinning and grab them while they're still available.
Happy trails to you until we meet again.